is Brock from LME Dragon. Today we're changing the lizard's cage. We're going from sand to paper towels. It's a lot better. Sand can clog up their digestive issues, like their digestive tract, and their cause death, basically. It's not good. I'm sick. I don't know if you can hear.
This is, I'm just getting out.
Because he's
pain.
He's always ready to be out. So, I don't know who's all heard, but Zeus and Athena locked on the 29th. And we're about a week into her being.
It's been a week.
Pregnant, yeah. We're a week, over a week. A week and a day after her and Zeus got into it. So hopefully in a couple more weeks we have eggs. We got an incubator, we got substrate for the eggs, all that good stuff.
And then for Athena, we are going to give her a sandbox for the eggs.
Yeah, wipe this out. We just put our extra, our old
sandbox. Yeah, we put it in something like that.
Big tank until that's full.
And then we just go dump it.
Put it in the trash. Sand. There's a whole controversy about the sand being your lizard substrate because it can cause their digestive system to be clogged or just holds in the nasty smells of the bearded dragons. It's harder to clean. I don't really bother me what I use. I haven't had an issue with it yet that we know of. Our one special lizard passed away, Frosty. He came home the other day and he was no longer with us. So Frosty passed away. I like to mist it so that way they stick to the bottom of the tank. Makes it easier. Just take your paper towel. Long enough. I like to spray the wall so when you have that overhang it sticks to the walls, but I didn't do that. Just take it, spray it all up, and your paper towel will stick to the wall, and you don't have it dangling everywhere and just having loose ends. Fun fact while we do this, bearded dragons have the same venom as a rattlesnake, but it's not harmful to humans. It'll be just like a bee sting. There's not enough venom in there. I'm just gonna do it over my plate. You could do her way, or you can just add another layer. I just add another layer over top. Just easier. Easy peasy. And I like to just remist the top of it. We had an issue with the hot spots and the cold spots of our bearded dragons. They were way too hot. Their hot spots were over 114 degrees, which is not good. And their cool spots were over 100 degrees. Granted, they're a warmer animal, and that's just how they are. But I prefer them not to be. I don't know if you can see on her, but she's starting to get ripples on the side of her belly. And you can start to feel, you see along my finger, you see the ripples. So hopefully that's a sign of her eggs forming. Granted, she was a little underweight whenever we did it. She was 220 grams. And they're recommended to be, 350? But as long as she's at the right age, like she's an adult, so all of her, she's full grown, so all that, they have room for her, I guess, her belly to expand.
He smells her.
So I don't think it's gonna hurt her in any way. For her being underweight, it's just the whole weight thing is more of a nutritious thing. If you're underweight, the lizards themselves don't feel as if they are nutritious enough to carry the eggs. So they, most of the time, don't feel ready to breed.
He smells Athena. His beard's getting dark and bobbing his head.
Just give it a show. He's saying hi to the viewers that are coming back. Talking to a lot of other bearded dragons, breeders. This guy, he the inner dragon, on Instagram a lot. He gave me the tips of the picked out that was a lot better than theories. So, shout out to the inner dragon on Instagram. Go check them out. He's got the cool, they're called the Red Monsters. Real deep dark red and kind of have like a lava look to them. Here, you still have the bottle set up there. Don't do that instead. So bearded dragons, you don't want a water dish in their tank. One, the humidity, they're not really a humid creature, humidity wise. Because they originate from Australia, if I'm not mistaken, so it's always hot and dry. And the bush, as they call it in Australia, outback, whatever. And then they overdrink themselves, and when they have their own water bowl in there and they overdrink, and then their handlers grab them, and they don't realize that they still have the water in their gullet, they're like a chicken. They fill up their mouth, they lift their heads up to drink it whenever they're ready to drink it. So they're like a chicken, they fill their mouth up and then they just lift their head up. And if you move them or disturb them while they're drinking, you can cause them to drown. Just fills their lungs up and drowns them. So why a water bowl is not recommended, because you don't realize that they drank out of the water bowl before you were to handle them, and then they drowned to death. It's just not a good thing. I think I'm gonna put an extra layer over the top of these, because these are really thin, so just add another layer on top so they have a good little base. Might even get a razor blade and come through and just flush it off. See what happens. So you're still just move around the tank though.
Hmm?
So I'm not gonna take back out, I'll just move around in the tank. Missed them over again. I figured that totes work pretty good for us. A lot more room.
Yeah, I do want to get her sandbox though.
So since she's close to laying eggs, people are asking me
I just gave her some water, so you're gonna have to wait a bit.
I'll come over. Yeah, it don't matter what sand you put in the sandbox, aquarium sand, fish sand, whatever. Lexi's operating the cameras, and that's why she's not on the camera today.
Wow, Zeus. No, Zeus. Zeus. Zeus, get down. He likes to be out, so I might just hold him. Oh, he sees Athena. Look. It's a tag bug. Okay, I gotcha. It's okay.
Just hold your sand and watch your tail, girl. In my little sandbox. She should be able to crawl up in that.
Ouch, Zeus, your nails are very sharp, bud.
I don't want to pick you up, so just try to crawl in. I'm not gonna pick her up because she just drank.
I mean, you can, it's been a couple minutes.
Just give them a little sandbox, and then she'll dig and bury her eggs, basically.
And then what's cool about this is the tub we're going to be using for her eggs.
Yeah, that's going to be her egg tote, so we're in the incubator.
Zeus! No, Zeus. No. Okay.
Just being a little butthead.
Okay, I'll take you out. Okay. He ripped right through that. So now they're really short. Come on. So when she has her eggs, we could just lift this up and out of it.
Pick the eggs up, put them in the substrate.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Throw them in the incubator.
We have to miss Rosie's too. Oh, Zeus, no. Zeus, Rock. Oh, Zeus, no. Zeus, no.
Hold on, technical difficulties. Zeus is on Lexi's back.
Zeusy woosy. I always have issues with him, all the time. He never wants to get off of me. He always climbs up on me. Okay. Nope, perfect. Right back, look.
That's alright, he'll be fine up there.
Hopefully, huh.
Since she has her little sandbox, she'll be fine. There. I'm gonna add a couple more layers to Zeus's.
He already ripped his from when he was trying to get out.
Excuse me.
I don't want to get too close to Dina. I don't want him to see her. Oh, sorry, guys. He's just adding enough more paper towels. But
you don't have to rip it to size. It really don't matter if you have an overhang to your paper towels in the tank, but it's just personal preference. I prefer there not to be an overhang, and I might even switch them to a mat of some sort at some point. going to a big reptile show at the end, beginning or the end of September?
Beginning of October.
Okay, the beginning of October in, what is it, Illinois?
Mm-hmm.
Illinois, one of the biggest reptile shows around.
Well, you might see us there.
We'll also,
LMK.
LMK will be there as long as he'll be getting another video this weekend of a couple new additions to our collection, which is going to be pretty cool.
Yep.
This is what Zeus does. She just crawls up on her back. We don't really need Athena's sandbox in there right now because she's still got
two to three weeks.
3 to 6 weeks yet.
No.
It'd be 4 weeks. It'd be 5 weeks. At the latest, 5 weeks. It's three to six weeks to lay eggs.
I thought it was 9 to 4.
Well, 3 to 6, I double checked. I thought it was 3 to 4 as well. Whenever you get the new paper towels and then we just get my cool off. So keep the tank temp down while you're doing the changing too. So their cool and hot spots don't get overwhelmed. Take longer for their hot spots to warm up, but their cool spots will be good. Their nails are sharp.
His nails are really, really sharp.
Well, the people that owned them before us did the mistake of clipping his nails.
Yes.
So now that his nails are regrowing, they come to a point.
Yeah, there's that one.
Like needles, which is.
I don't know if he's gonna let me get his front ones to show.
I don't think he would want to clip his dragon nails because Rosie and Athena's nails are not like that. They've never been clipped. Athena's actually playing in her sand.
Or she's going to the bathroom.
But this is how we change our substrates and our change to a new substrate. Lexi's gonna be having surgery on the 16th, so that'll be about the time that our eggs are laid, hopefully. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and if you guys have any questions about what substrates are what lizards are better, what morphs you want to see. We're going to be getting a video with LMK for our new additions. I hope you guys will enjoy what we got, and we'll see you guys next time.